Hello. In this video, we'll take a look at several small but welcome new features in SpectraLayers 12 that'll make your editing life easier. The new addition features automatic plosive reduction in its own dedicated module. Here's an unprocessed speech sample we can work on.
Plosive speech sounds, P. Plosive speech sounds, P.
Select the DePlosive module. The dialog opens, and I've positioned it right next to the target. And here I've refined my view in the display panel so that we can better see what's happening. Now here I've zoomed in for an even better view, and I have my cursor pointing directly at the 50 Hz point on the spectrograph. You can use this as a visual reference. In the module, the threshold control adjusts for sensitivity, and in the case of speech plosives, the 1 dB minimum will usually be best. The frequency limit control is important. It sets the upper limit of the attenuation effect. I'm going to preview the effect up the range. 50 Hz.
Plosive speech sounds, P.
80.
Plosive speech sounds, P.
You can hear more frequencies being attenuated as I work up the range. 100 Hz.
Plosive speech sounds, P.
And 200 Hz.
Plosive speech sounds, P.
When you have the results you like, simply apply the process and you're finished. The phase rotation module allows you to correct asymmetrical waveforms to maximize gain before clipping, resulting in cleaner, more balanced audio with improved headroom. Listen to this sax riff. Brass instruments, especially when mic'd from the bell, often exhibit asymmetrical waveforms because the sound is primarily produced by the player blowing into the instrument, creating a more dominant pressure on one side of the waveform. Here I'm expanding the waveform display, and you can see some asymmetry in the waveform. Over in the modules panel, I'm selecting the phase rotation module. Command Z selects the entire layer. Hitting the suggest button calculates the correction, and here you can see that it's 85 degrees. Apply the process, and the layer is updated with corrected phase. The view filtering options in relevant panels, including default categories and custom presets, have been enhanced by the addition of a keyword-based search option. For example, typing noise in the modules panel instantly filters and displays all available noise shaping processes. This makes it faster and easier to locate specific tools, streamlining your workflow and minimizing interruptions during editing. The history panel now consolidates successive operations from a single tool, typically a drawing tool, into a single undoable step. This optimizes the edit history and simplifies the undo process. Okay, here I have the eraser tool, and I'm making 5 quick moves with it, separated by mouse clicks. Here in the history panel, you can see that all 5 clicks were recorded as one event. Here I'm performing a Command Z undo operation, and the 5 moves are undone all at once. The feature is always active. Under the System tab in the Preferences panel, you can set the maximum time interval that the program will allow for merging actions. The default is 1.5 seconds. This helps keep your history list clean and manageable, making it easier to navigate and reverse clustered edits. Frequency fading now scales by octaves instead of hertz, resulting in a more natural and consistent visual representation across the spectrum. Fades now appear smoother and more predictable from top to bottom, better reflecting how we actually perceive sound. Intensive AI-assisted processing on large files can sometimes take a lot of time to complete. In version 12, we've made it easier to determine how long a process is going to take, and we've also made it easier to smoothly cancel processing and get back to where we started from if we need to. Here I'm selecting the Unmix Song module. I have all the instrument boxes checked, and I'm selecting High Quality Mode, which takes the most processing time. Now, the processing time estimate updates continuously and more precisely as the operation progresses. The program interface remains fully responsive, allowing you to cancel processing at any point, saving time and maintaining an uninterrupted workflow. Tool and module presets are now saved as files within folders that can be transferred between computers or between SpectraLayers versions, starting with version 12. The folder's default location is shown here in Preferences under the System tab. On a Mac, this folder will probably be invisible, but can be temporarily exposed by typing Command-Shift-Period. Now I'm in the VST3 effects module and I'm sharing my screen with the presets folder, which I have open on the right. And this is a good time to point out that the VST3 effects module can now display multiple plugin interfaces simultaneously, so you can tweak and preview entire chains at once. Click Save, and now you can see the new preset appear in its folder. Deleting the preset deletes it from the folder, so it's permanently erased. And finally, SpectraLayers 12 runs natively on Windows ARM for quiet, power-efficient performance with growing Pro App support. These new utilities and visualization options round out the program as it continues its journey at the vanguard of spectral music production, sound design, restoration, and repair. We hope you enjoyed this video. SpectraLayers delivers state-of-the-art spectral processing for editors in every field. Subscribe to the Steinberg YouTube channel and learn more about how you can leverage this application in your production workflow.